Invasive species are non-native or exotic plants and animals that do not naturally occur in Wisconsin's waters. They cause ecological or economic harm. Invasive species cover all of Wisconsin's lakes. They disrupt the aquatic ecosystems and make it difficult for the native species to thrive. The round goby in particular has been invading Wisconsin's lakes for over 20 years. The rise in the round goby population has begun to affect major lake predators and other surrounding native species. According to the Wisconsin Sea Grant Organization, the goby is 4 to 10 inches long and lives in all four of the Great Lakes and majority of Wisconsin's interior lakes. It is usually gray and brown in color and sometimes has spots on its body, including a well-known spot on its dorsal fin, which is commonly black or green. Also stated by the Wisconsin Sea Grant, gobies are bottom-dwelling fish. They have well-developed sensory systems that enhances their ability to detect movement underwater. This allows them to feed in complete darkness. Another unique characteristic about the goby is that it has a sectorial disc. The sectorial disc is located on the pelvic fin and is used as a suction cup so that the goby can settle on the bottom of lakes. This is used when in search of food and helps them to stay low to the ground while in fast-moving waters. Round gobies reproduce repeatedly during the summer months. A mother goby can lay up to 5,000 eggs at a time. The female hides the eggs under rocks, debris, and hard-to-seek places so that no one can harm them. In an interview with Tom Kroger from the Department of Natural Resources of Wisconsin, he stated that round gobies are very aggressive eaters. They eat clams, insect larvae, small fish, fish eggs, and their favorite, zebra mussels. They can eat up to 78 zebra mussels a day. The round goby was originally found in Europe and Asia, where it was discovered in the Black and Caspian Seas. This sneaky hitchhiker would attach to the bottom of ships that would depart from the shores, and soon they arrived in the United States. It was first discovered in 1990 in the St. Clair River, located in southeastern Michigan. The population continued to grow before the states noticed that the round goby was an issue, so prevention was delayed, and the damage was already done. Tom Kroger also stated that round gobies typically reproduce more often than the other native lake fish. This means that eventually the round gobies will take over the bottom water of lakes and the natives won't be able to thrive. The gobies gang up on native lake fish and water snakes, but occasionally they get a taste of their own medicine. Smallmouth bass, walleye, lake trout, and other native lake fish have a hard time staying alive because the gobies steal their food. Ontario's Invading Species Awareness Program, as well as Tom Kroger, state that as of now, there aren't any specific guidelines that local organizations can follow to prevent the spread of this species. The goby population is growing too quickly for anyone to help the situation. If you find a goby, kill it. It is illegal to have possession of a round goby, and never put them back in the water alive. So save the lakes, spread the word, and stop aquatic hitchhikers.